all here and present their form of art. And most of the people in this country are now good experts of these country music and literature, as I know. And sometimes to us also it becomes little careful. We have to be in presenting our performance, because now I don't know in hundreds and thousands people, even if one person is sitting very, very critical eye and ear, and who has been heard the best musicians and artists of Indian music, who has spent years and years in learning and understanding Indian music, and he may know all the faults and good points and bad points of Indian music, and so later on he may suddenly declare, oh, they are poor. So it is now rather very, I enjoy to see in this country that really I started coming to this country from 1951, when I was composer and director of Uday Shankar's troupe, Uday Shankar's Hindu ballet. Those days, certainly, very few people knew about Indian music, and very few artists from other countries used to come. But now it is quite different. And so, when I am speaking about Indian music here, I don't mean, I can't think that you don't know anything about it. Certainly you know, but even some expert may come and teach me about Indian music and I have to listen to it. So that way, few things which recently, within our 5-10 years researches, some results and some few things we have came to know, that if you see the map of old world, in Far East we have China and Japan and Indonesia and Bali, etc., etc., so many countries. In Middle Eastern area we have Persian, Iran, Baghdad, and several countries. And then this Europe side starts. Musically, if I see, then I find the Western countries, including USSR and USA, is almost one. They have different schools, Italian school, English school, French school, now American school and USSR school of Western music, but it is all Western music, Western system of music. Now, Beethoven and Bach and all these great composers are considered great composers of their music all over the Western countries. Middle Eastern countries have their different music, different scale. That side, Chinese music has totally different scale and different thing. Now, in between, Indian music is again totally different. Some people have tried to understand Indian music either through Middle Eastern music or through Chinese music. But they have, I should say, failed to reach the correct point of the Indian music. Because there are certain things. Middle Eastern music has different type of scale, the fundamental thing. Western music has a scale. The original scale was diatonic, now it's tempered scale because of these key instruments, and equally divided into 12 parts, the one octave, that is tempered scale, but it is still very little minute difference between the diatonic. And the diatonic scale is exactly the scale in which is in India used. since last about 2005 years, as we get the information regarding that. So, in ancient period, this is very surprising that Western scale and Indian scale was similar. Now, whatever reference you get about the melodies in Western countries and melodies in Indian music, they are also almost same in BCs. In 80s, they started bifurcating and they started developing their own ways. Now, around 11th, 12th, 13th century, in Western countries, people, musicians, went to counterpoint and counter melody, and then after that, to harmony. In India, instead of simple melody, they went inside to start using notes different way. Different way means, this is very simple. Sa ga pa da pa ga sa ga pa sa pa ga. You can have variations. Ga ga pa ga sa pa ga dha pa ga pa sa ga pa ga. That will several variations. This is one thing. But in India, people started giving more importance to the approach of the note. Note certainly is important. Ga, re, da, na, 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 na. Important. But, re, da, now see this note. Re, da, ra, a. Wires or go from this point to that point and then come over here, go this way or go there or go straight jerking or go smoothly, so many ways. So they got busy in using notes in a different, with different approach. So the approach became very, very minute and broad-based to spend whole life for Indian musician. So that's how the Indian music, though according to Western terminology, remained in melody, but not simple melody. It's very difficult to understand how note is moving from one place to another place. And that, please try to see, even she has taken training, as Dr. Buck introduced, Nancy Nalbandian, she is American. She has taken training and now she can move, her approach of the notes is also just like an Indian artist will do. And from there you can see how one note is moving to another note, in a simple way sometimes, but in more very complicated, difficult way. And the second thing, in India, while using singing and playing music, we prefer to select few notes from a scale. We don't like to use all the notes at a time. Prefer to have few notes in the scale. For example, ra 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 na. This scale is also used in Western music. Ra 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 ra. If this has been taken, then the name has been given Rag Bhupali. Now, in the name of Bhupali, whole India will sing these notes. And an artist, if he has started this rag, then he will use only these notes, no other notes. and all his imagination, all his creativity will be completed or spread over only in these five notes. Ra 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 ra. Now, other artists may start doing something else. Ra 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 na 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 ra na 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 na. This is another scale. Now, this artist, in the name of Raag Des, will continue to use notes, or only these notes, no other notes. And according to when you use some definite notes, then gradually you start experiencing. I'll just tell you. You just start. You feel. Which one is soft and suitable for morning? Which one is harsh and suitable for daytime or evening? Sa da da na 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 da na 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 da da na 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 na. This is one tune. Another ra da na ri da na 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 ri da na 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 da na. This one is subtly soft than the previous one, and so this way, considering the character of the note and the combination of notes, in India people started deciding that this rag should be sung in morning and this should be sung in the evening, or this in daytime or this in night time. So today we are going to present evening rags. We cannot sing or play morning rags, sorry, because we feel that if we sing or play morning rags, then we will be cursed by those rags. Because it's a tendency in India, in everything, gradually we start putting life and then start relating those things with us as they are alive. And if we don't treat them properly, certainly if you don't treat somebody on the street properly, he's going to perhaps hit you. So the same way, if a person, if a thing which is I'm using is not happy with me, then certainly he's going to curse us. And so with that belief, we never sing morning rag in the evening or evening rag in the morning. So this is one thing. Now, after the notes, we have very complicated rhythmic system. It's not only two, three or four beats group, but we have 8 beats, 10 beats, 12 beats, 15 beats, 16 beats, 18 beats, tal. Tal means another way. It's not exactly that way, but a little bit you can understand if somebody says that it's a poetic meter. Poetry has meter, and the meter indicates one whole line. This much big line, which may have 20 beats or 14 beats or 10 beats or 16 beats, like that. So it is like poetic meter. We have tal, definite beats are there, and the tabla player, drummer, starts playing it with the composition, and then come the singer or player and the tabla player, they try to remain in that tal, and plus they continue to improvise. And improvisation then depends on once on him and another time on the drummer. Now, if both do not have a good relation, then there may be actual fight on the stage. That sometimes happens in India. So anyway, you will see what goes on today. About the instrument, certainly we have different instrument than every nation has different type of instruments. But in few things, as Dr. Bhatt said, in few things India has gone very far ahead, even in very ancient period, in making instruments. For example, I'll show you these tablas. This black spot is, this is the reason why this skin has that much resonance and the continuity of the sound. And this is the reason why this can be tuned to a particular pitch. So this invention of this black material, which can be put on the skin and the sound may be increased, actually started around 2000 years from now. And they knew how to make sound better. Now, other thing, you'll be surprised to know that though every country in ancient period has different instruments, Babylonia, Assyria, Mishra, Egyptian culture or the Greek culture, everybody has some little identical different instruments. But on principle, they were all same, including India. Means everybody, in the name of string instrument, they had one similar principle, that if they want to use one note, they will have one wire. Maybe two wire, maybe four wire. But a number of wire and number of note were same. Nobody knew how to produce more note from one wire. That actually we could get in India around 3rd century BC. And the Veena, which was discovered at that time, was called Ghoshvati Veena. And the Vichitra Veena, which I am going to play today, is a kind of developed form of that Ghoshvati Veena. Ghoshvati Veena used to have only one string. This Veena has few more strings to get more broader pitch and broader area of the sound. Now, I may say that in India, all the strings instrument were called in a common name of Veena. All the instruments were Veena. There was a time when the Sitar, everybody knows this instrument is a Sitar. This was also called Veena. And the name of this instrument was Tritantri Veena. Later on, it was difficult for Muslims to call this name, so they translated it into Sitar, and gradually it became Sitar. But it is also a Tritantri Veena. So there were several Veenas in throughout India people used to play. Still, whatever strings instrument we have, all have older names. For example, the sarod is the old Chitra Veena. The sitar is old Tritantri Veena. And other Veenas we have still popular, Saraswati Veena, Rudra Veena, and several other Veenas. The Shantu, that is also a little confusing. You may have heard shantir or santir, a instrument which even Iran and Baghdad and Iraq, this side people also play santir. Now, we also play that in the name of shantur, and it is believed that actually shantur is a changed name of Shatatantri Veena. Shatatantri Veena's changed Shattar and then Shantur. Its word is deriving from there automatically. So the Shatatantri Veena means the Veena of 100 strings. Unfortunately, this Santir and Shantur, the present day used, still has 100 strings in it. So, later on, we developed an instrument in which more notes could be produced in one wire. Then it was around 7th or 8th century when we could get the frets. And the first veena was Kinnari veena, fretted veena. Later on, with the development of other type of instrument and music, the sitar, which was called Tritantri Veena those days, resulted. And now this instrument is most popular instrument in India, and I think it has a very nice sound and the possibility of producing sound. I have taken enough time in explaining things, and I think it will be better that if you see what goes on here, and if at the end, if there is any question, certainly I'll be happy to answer that.